What's going on, Smith?
Well, we refuse to move until we get a fair and unbiased inquiry into Sharon Gilmore's death.
You serious?
I've never been more serious in all my life, Mr. Fletcher.
Of them are there?
Nine. Smith's mob.
I thought you said Bryant was the one demanding to see me.
Well, she is, but Smith's backing her up.
All security gates are locked and the rest of the women are in their cells.
Good.
I thought I gave instructions that all mention of the inquest was to be taken out of the papers.
Yeah, well, it was, but, well, my guess is they found out from Anderson. She'd been let out for the day.
Why do they always think that the system is working against them?
We want the governor. 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 We want the governor.
The only thing you'll get from this is solitary. No one's going to listen to a pack of yelling animals.
In case you haven't noticed.
We want the governor.
This is a peaceful demonstration and we've got a legitimate complaint.
That's right. We're going to stay out on strike until we are heard.
You're a fool, Bryant. Why don't you ask Smith how these things end up? She's had a lot of practice in getting people hurt or killed in order to get her own way.
We thought we'd take a leaf out of your book, Vera.
You screws got what you wanted when you went on strike.
Yeah, and we were the ones who still copped being locked up all that time. We could have all died of starvation before you came looking for us.
You'll never learn, will you? There's a big difference between the behaviour of normal people and rabble like you.
And the difference is we haven't got any rights, and that's what this is all about.
You're criminals. You don't deserve any rights.
We want the governor. We want the governor. We want the governor.
Thank you, Miss Bennett.
We want the governor.
Shut up.
I was under the impression you knew. I am always prepared to listen to any complaints or worries you may have. But in my office, at the right time and in a civilized manner.
Well, we want much more than just a good ear. We want something done about this.
Yeah, we want action.
We want action. We want action.
I won't be dictated to, Bryant. If you have something to say, say it.
We want action.
Okay, build up.
All right. Now, you say to me that Sharon was killed accidentally, right?
That is correct.
Sharon was murdered, and a screw in here murdered her. Now, I want you to get your chief to organize another inquest. Only this time, we want Jock Stewart convicted.
Don't be ridiculous. I was at the hearing and there was nothing to indicate she was murdered.
That's just because she was a crim. They wouldn't care how she snapped it, just as long as there's one less to worry about.
Built up.
Listen, why the hell didn't they get me on the stand? I mean, he told me he murdered her, goddammit.
Yeah, and if he bashed into me, he could have killed Sharon real easy.
Right.
We think Judy's got a good point. Now, she might only be interested in seeing that Sharon's murderer gets what he deserves, but we see it this way. We let one screw get away with bashing and killing, and we leave ourselves wide open for the next punchy screw that comes along.
That's right. We could all be raped in our sleep.
Mr. Stewart will not be working in prisons again.
Oh, big deal. He still gets away with it, doesn't he? Listen, we're not moving from here until something is done about it.
Yeah, we want action. We want action. We want action.
Suit yourself. I'm sure you'll think slightly differently after spending a night in here.
We want action.
Perhaps in the morning you'll listen to reason.
We want action.
And if you get any ideas about damaging the prison property, it'll be your loss because it won't be replaced.
We want action.
Breaks my heart.
We want action. We want action. We want action.
We want action. We want action.
We can try and get them back in their cells.
Well, somebody might get hurt. I think an uncomfortable night would do more good. Besides, I'd rather they get it out of their system, away from the other women. Yeah. Would you check the other cells, please?
Yes, certainly.
It's easy for a cause like this to spread right through the prison. Then we'd really have our hands full.
Put Smith and Bryant in solitary. Then the others will come to their senses.
Martyrs only make matters worse, and they think we had something to hide. No, we'll see if they're calmer in the morning. Would you see that there's somebody, an officer, on duty all night, please, Miss Bennett?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And if possible, try to ignore them. It's pointless adding more fuel to the fire.
Sharon was murdered! Sharon was murdered! Sharon was murdered!
think, babe?
Sharon was
well,
murdered.
I don't think Davis
Sharon
is going to lose
murdered.
Any sleep over it.
Sharon yeah, that's was what murdered. I think. Sharon
why the hell
murdered.
Didn't they listen to
Sharon
us?
Sharon was murdered.
They never
Sharon
pay any attention
murdered.
To us until we sit up and
Sharon
make them.
Sharon was murdered. Sharon was murdered.
I haven't been here a few Sharon days. Oh, we must have just interrupted her night in the toes. Yeah. She's the way she was dolled up.
Davis, all right, she'll come good, won't she be?
She's still part of the system, and she thinks the system is always right.
Oh, what's going on?
Flame in hell.
Lights out.
But Mrs. Barry, we can't see what we're doing.
Well, you should have thought of that before you started anything.
The telly's not working either.
They must have pulled the plug on us.
You know, she's not wrong.
What?
I reckon we played our hand too fast.
Yeah, well, why did you go along with me? You got a better idea?
No, I haven't. But I've got all night to think of one. Winks.
Did you come up with anything?
Depends on Judy.
I want to go to the loo.
Hang on for a bit longer.
Don't reckon I can.
Think about something else. What about Kevin?
Oh, yeah. Gee, we had a real good time yesterday, B. We ate out, and then I had all these things that I was supposed to do, you know, but we spent the time... Oh, well, at the flat, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that reminds me, I've got to tell Lizzie something.
What?
Oh, well, Kevin. Kevin reckons that Marcy is ripping her off, that she's not really her daughter. I couldn't really follow it. Anyhow, it was something Josie let slip. But Kevin told Mr. Reed and he's doing some checking, but I thought I'd better warn Lizzie just in case.
Hold your horses for a second. You sure Kevin's got his story straight? Is he positive that this character's a con artist?
Well, no, not really.
Well, then leave it.
Hey?
Look, this is the best thing that's ever happened to Lizzie. She's suddenly got herself a daughter and a granddaughter. So this person's a fraud. So what?
Yeah, but what if they're after Lizzie's compo money?
Well, we'll worry about that even when it happens. Just dry up for the minute.
Okay.
Feels like I've been kicked downstairs. Oh, I only meant... Oh, geez, Lizzie, you got a fag?
They'll stunt your growth. Oh, I slept like a log.
Officer Barry, I have to go to the toilet.
Sit down, Lorna.
It's all right for you, but I've got a wee bladder. Come on.
Just a minute. Come in. We can wait, you know. You'll all have to come out eventually, and we'll pick you up, one by one. Lock her in a cell.
Come on.
You pig!
Rotten mongrel!
Sleep well, did you, ladies?
Oh, shut up!
Yes. Listen, did you think any more about what I said last night?
Of course.
We've got to stick together on this, otherwise we're going to get nowhere.
Yeah. I'm with you.
Fletch, any chance of Judy and me seeing the governor?
That depends whether you're going to be sensible about all this.
I think we've got it sorted out.
Oh, we can't chuck it in now. Not after what we went through last night.
What you'll go through today will be a whole lot worse if you don't keep your trap shut. We've had enough, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, come on.
Would it be too much to suggest that the security gates remain locked?
Good idea. Could I leave that with you? Come in. I trust we can discuss this calmly.
We want to know how to go about getting a new inquest.
Unless you have fresh evidence, it cannot be done.
You gave Stewart the boot. You must think he's guilty too, Mrs. Davidson.
Mr. Stewart was suspended because of accusations against him. The department investigated, and as I told you, he will not be working in prisons anymore.
Well, that means they think he's guilty too.
He was investigated over the matter of striking Doreen.
and it was decided there was enough doubt to relieve him of his position, nothing more.
But what about Sharon? I mean, he told me he killed her.
I know how you felt about her, Bryant. And as I told you, your accusations were investigated. But the police were unable to find sufficient proof to back it up. The inquest ruled it as accidental death. Now you will just have to accept that.
Yeah, fair enough.
Bryant?
Yeah, sure.
I trust we will hear no further on the matter, either from you or any of the other women.
I'll tell them.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
If you ask me, Smith gave in just a little bit too easily.
Yes, I tend to agree with you.
We could have stuck it out longer.
Well, I couldn't have.
I thought you lot were meant to be tough.
Oh, come on, don't stand around all day. Well, where is everyone?
Well, we're going to keep the whole prison waiting just for you, Smith.
Now, why didn't I think of that? I would have said it was because you didn't want us to spread the good oil to the rest of them.
What's Mrs. Davidson going to do, B?
Nothing. She's just like the rest of them.
Come on, Birdsworth, keep it moving. Not there, over here. Come on.
Ah! Oh, anyone would reckon we hadn't got any rights.
And I don't want you two sitting together either. Come on.
Or what? You're going to wait for us on the stairs like your mate?
Ah, go on, let him have his fun. It makes him feel like a big man.
Listen, I don't know whether Davidson's bought it or not. We've got to make out that we've forgotten about our pound of flesh, right?
Look, if she's not going to do anything about it, then it's up to us. We gotta let the outside world know what it's really like in this place. And the only way we can do that is through the newspapers.
Yeah, but we can't just ring up the papers and say, we've got a story.
This afternoon, when we go out for exercise, we're gonna demonstrate.
Demonstrate what, B?
Injustice, Lizzie. Get as many women together as we can. We're gonna have to outnumber the screws.
Mm-hmm. You mean we're gonna riot?
Will you just eat your breakfast, for God's sake?
Well, they'll just call the cops or the fire brigade. The papers mightn't even get here.
I know that's a risk. We're going to have to hold out until they do.
What if we get word to them and tell them what's going to happen in advance?
How?
Noeline's coming in this morning. She said she would anyway.
Is that your mum?
She can get a message out for us. Noeline wouldn't help us if her life depended on it.
She'd do it for me. She hates the screws as much as you know, do.
Okay, say she did go to the papers. How do we know that they'd believe her? What with her record, they'd probably think she was some kind of nut.
Noeline's holding Anne a good job now. She's trying real hard to be respectable, so there. It's worth a try.
We can't be expected to watch you 24 hours a day. So whenever there isn't an officer on duty, this remains locked. Animals like you deserve to be in a cage.
Bitch!
Dora and Lizzie, hand me some of those sheets.
But they're on to us, B.
Ah, no, that's just Vera flexing her muscles. They won't take any notice of us taking our daily constitutional. They're keeping an eye on us on the inside, not the outside.
What are you doing?
come in handy.
Honey, this is a peaceful demonstration.
Just for protection?
Yeah, I know, but all we're going to do is barricade the front doors so that the screws don't follow B's lot out.
There's going to be a couple of screws left in the garden. Just in case they start turning rough, that's all.
You'll never get away with that. I mean, they check everything before we finish work.
Yeah, I know. And it's three forks they're going to count. I learned that one in Winlayton. By the time they cotton on, it'll be too late.
Wasting me bloody time having to go through all this rubbish.
You should know the rules better than anyone, Bourke.
Well, well, the face that sunk a thousand ships.
Hand over your bag.
I've counted it all. Well, I know we could go on chatting like this all day, Vera. But I think I'd better see me daughter first.
She was in some trouble last night, Bourke. I doubt if she's allowed to have visitors.
But I rung up. I got time off from work and everything.
You wouldn't know what work was.
Oh, yeah, that shows all you know. I got a real good job.
You are.
Sorry I couldn't bring in your dirty pictures.
It's all right. I've got a very good memory. Mrs. Davidson, Noeline Burke's here to see Leanne. I suggest that in the light of last night's performance, the visit should be cancelled. If you say so. Sign the visitor's book.
Still haven't found out a way to run the prison yet, eh, Vera?
I'd want her searched. Thoroughly. And I don't care how long it takes.
Getting here, didn't you?
Yeah, had to entertain the troops.
You got 5 minutes, Bourke.
Is that all?
Some people waste so much time being smart.
How you been going?
All right, thanks.
Been keeping your nose clean?
Yeah, of course.
Should go lying to me, you little bugger.
One guess who dog mean.
Yeah, you listen to me. This place isn't like that nursery you've been used to. You got 2 months to go, and when you get out, I want you to come and be my assistant at work. Pays real well.
Yeah?
Yeah. Anyone been giving you any trouble?
No. Even made a few friends.
Good, he's still here. Reckon it must be getting to him by now. Yeah, he looks as if he could do with a bit. Aren't you looking after him, Vera?
That's enough, Bourke.
You're just as disgusting as ever, Bourke. I'm going to cut this visit back to 2 minutes.
I reckon that'd get rid of her.
I was wondering how I could get you on your own.
Kidneys.
You got to help us, Noel. Friend of his was murdered near you by a screw. Hmm? He's gone now, but no one will believe he done it. So we need someone to tell the papers that we're going to take over the garden salvo when we're out exercising. Hold a rigid digi demo like you see on the news and stuff. We're getting as many together
Who's
as we can.
Who's we?
Oh, Judy and me and B and...
I'm not lifting a finger to help bloody Smith. I suppose she put you up to this.
No, it's my idea.
Oh, how many times do I have to tell you not to think for yourself? You're always getting a strike.
Hell, Noeline, you've
Don't you bloody swear at your mother or you'll wind up with a thick ear. You stay out of trouble, you hear? I didn't hear you. He's always trying to be top dog.
Just forget it then.
She what?
Well, you said that you were worried about it breaking up before the papers got here.
Well, what do you think this lot's for? You make enough smoke. The press are always on the tail of the fire brigade.
Well, Leanne thought she'd talk her into it to be on the safe side.
The safe side. Noeline Burke's not going to go helping us. More likely she's going to go lagging to the screws. Why didn't she tell me this before?
She's not much choppy, but she might come good.
You and I might be the Queen of Sheba. Oh, for goodness sake, let's get rid of all this stuff. If they are on to us and they can't get the evidence to back it up, we might just bluff it through.
Well, what about all that stuff in our cells? Well, we could say it was there from the last time we were going to go on strike.
You reckon they believe us?
Well, it's the truth,
yeah,
isn't it?
Shut up, you two. I'm trying to think. We need someone who can get into our block. Lizzie, I think it's about time you had another one of your turns.
Oh, I was beginning to think I was out of practice.
Oh, you're too carried away.
Is anyone there?
Yes.
Help! Help!
Lizzie's coming.
Come on.
We're just going to really bad this time. This is very
come on.
Oh, I'll be all right if I could have a bit of a lie down.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. Oh. You'll be all right. But we'll make sure the nurse sees you when she comes on duty.
Just been working too hard. Oh, it's hard to accept that you're not still a spring chicken.
I know, Lizzie. We all feel that way. It happened to us.
Well, if Noeline Bourke has Dobbs in, we'll soon know about it.
I don't know what you're looking for, Vera. Leanne never slipped me nothing. Who'd you get a kick out of perving into other people's things?
You must be very proud of her, Bourke. She takes after you, a real little troublemaker. You'll be lucky if she gets out in 2 months the way she's going.
She'll stay clean.
Not if she hangs around Smith's group. You should know that. Now sign out.
It isn't her you should be looking out for.
No?
Oh, I don't want my daughter getting in any trouble.
That happened the day she was born.
Oh, if she wasn't so busy making flaming wisecracks, you might have noticed Smith's organising a surprise party.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, not so funny now, are you?
Why should I believe anything you say?
Because I want to look after Leanne, that's why.
Why, something, Fletch.
Must be his washing.
Oh, so sorry. I warned him not to let it yet. Oh, we are so popular today. Oh.
Be quiet, Smith.
There could have been, no. It's not worth taking any chances.
For the next few days, you'll be confined inside the building. There will be no exercise periods until I decide otherwise.
Oh, come off it. Mrs. Davidson will go stark, staring mad, cooped up in here. You might just as well put us in solitary.
That could be easily arranged, Smith.
What are you trying to do? Push us over the edge.
The major security gates will be kept locked. However, the intermediary ones will be opened, and you will also be allowed to have your meals with the other inmates.
Oh, gee whiz, thanks.
I shall review the situation in a few days' time.
All right, you heard the bell. Come on, get moving.
Well, that's blown it.
We're not finished yet.
Well, how are we going to get outside?
The governor is going to give us a hand.
So we dropped out of the popularity polls.
Well, if it isn't Queen, fix it.
Yeah, thanks you lot. You just cut off our fresh air supply. Haven't any good strikes lately?
What? What's going on?
Well, why don't you ask little Miss Blabbermouth here?
She let her mother in on it. Guess who went to the screws and lagged? She never. Noel's not a lagger, honest.
Then would you care to explain why we are not allowed to go out into the garden and why the screws are turning this place upside down, trying to find something to pin on us?
Did they find anything?
I'm not really hungry, Mrs. J.
Well, the sister said you were perfectly all right, Lizzie.
I feel rotten. I couldn't keep a thing down.
Oh, well, suit yourself.
It doesn't look like it, but they're still suspicious.
Not like Lizzie to go after food.
Keep it moving, Bourke. You too, Bryant.
Do you think Noeline was just out to stir?
Well, I wouldn't put it past her, but you can never tell.
Now, what was that you were saying, Phil?
Oh, nothing, B.
Be in the laundry in an hour. Bring as many of your mates with you as you can.
What for?
You were going to get some fresh air. You still want to have a crack at David?
Oh, sure. And how are we going to get there? She's going to listen to us this time?
If you had an hour alone with her, she might listen to you. I bet you could even get her to ring the press.
Margo will help you, won't you, Margo?
You want us to take over the governor's office?
We're going to need someone to keep Nip, though.
Have me.
No, I don't want a Bourke having anything to do with this.
Can't blame me for what, Noel. Bugger, I can do what I like.
You're out.
Listen, let her alone. She's only trying to help.
No! What about you, Lizzie? Do you reckon you can handle it?
Oh, yeah. That'll be all right. How do we get there?
I've got a little rule here. Make the punishment fit the crime. You and Margo do as I say, you'll get close enough to the governor.
And what'll you be doing?
I will be getting demonstration number two underway.
I'm still not feeling myself, Mrs. Jackson. One more day in that sweat box and I don't think I'd last. Couldn't you find me a job in the kitchen or making the afternoon teas or something?
Well, if you're that ill, Lizzie, I think you'd probably better go and lie down.
Oh, well, I'm not that crook. I expect I'm a bit down because I won't be seeing my family for 2 days. Better keep busy.
All right, then. You go and see Cook.
Oh, you've got a heart of gold, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, that's just great, isn't it? Not that Lizzie's any great loss, but we were short-handed as it was.
Funny how some people get it easy. I'll have to get her to give me lessons.
Put on 40 years and you've got it made.
Yeah. You two seem to have a lot of time on your hands. You can start by helping in the laundry. Just a minute. What are you doing with that?
Well, I thought we were the only two allowed out in the garden. But I don't care.
Get it out of here.
Now, what are you waiting for, Smith?
Next bin out of here.
Next bin out of here. Go on, move it along.
Hey, watch what you're doing. Keep it moving, Gaffney.
Well, then keep out of my way, stupid.
Oh, I'm sick of you. It's your fault we're stuck in here.
Come on,
Gaffney. After you've cleaned up that mess, you can take it outside. You two can spend the afternoon cleaning the floors. And if they're not spotless, you can keep on doing them until they are.
Listen, it's me you should be punishing, you know, Miss Bennett. I mean, she had nothing to do with it.
She's a Bourke, and they're always in trouble.
Move it, Gaffney. Come on, Bourke.
Look, the blankets are for us. And put some of the signs with them as well.
Hey, I like this one.
Yeah, this is ours too.
She's coming.
Bloody Vera, she's given the job to Leanne.
Well, Margot's with her. She'll know what to do, won't she?
The only thing keeping Margot's ears apart is that stupid great skull of hers. No, Judy's going to have to figure a way out of getting to Davidson. I hope she gets there.
Where does that leave us?
We go ahead as planned.
Well, we still need the keys.
That's why Judy's got to get there, to make sure those two morons don't louse things up.
It's her ball game. Maybe we ought to forget the whole thing.
We listen to Mick Mouse over here. Have you any idea why we're making a stand on this?
No.
Because I think like Judy does. A screw actually got away with murdering one of us. Now, I don't care if she's a no-hoper or not. No one. Not Davidson or the screws or the courts are going to shove this under a rug. And just in case you've all been listening to Vera too much, we're not animals, we're human beings. You spend enough time in this rat trap, though, and you start forgetting it. They try to treat us like zombies. So for the rest of your life, you think, if you can think at all, that you are just a piece of dirt. And you keep on getting swept right under that rug.
You can put that down, Bryant. Now that you're out here, you might as well do a bit of work.
Miss Bennett, I've got to see the governor now.
Don't you dare speak to me like that, Bryant.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. It's just that it's really important.
I'll decide that.
It's about the demonstration. You know what that Bourke woman said? She wasn't making it up.
How do you know Bourke told us anything?
Well, that wasn't too difficult to work out. Why else are the women all inside? Anyway, that won't work. They're still going ahead with the demonstration. And I know how they're going to do it.
I thought Leanne was supposed to be working in the garden. What went wrong?
It's a punishment. She's been in some trouble in the dining room.
After the talking to Ike, why do I keep on asking for miracles?
Well, with her sort of background, it'd need a miracle to change her.
Yeah, well, the youngest ones are always the hardest to crack, and they're so unpredictable.
I'm not so sure after dealing with Smith for so many years.
Yeah, anyway, I came to talk to you about Lizzie Birdsworth's family. Do you know much about her children?
Well, only what she's told me. Why, is something wrong?
No, maybe nothing. But the granddaughter, Josie, said to Kevin Burns that Marcia and her brothers were brought up in the orphanage. Now, according to the home's records and according to what Lizzie's already told us, both sons were fostered out very early in the piece.
Well, Josie's very young. She could have mixed things up.
Yeah, I know, but it still bothers me. Lizzie's never given any indication that she knows what became of her two sons, but according to Josie, her uncle works as a butcher in Sale. Now, the name's different, but then he could have changed that by deed poll for some reason or other.
Well, perhaps he doesn't want Lizzie to know anything about him.
Yeah, I thought of that. Anyway, I thought it might be worthwhile checking through this jigsaw.
Come in.
Thought you might like a cup of tea, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, thank you, Lizzie. Mr. Reed?
No, thanks. I've got a lot of work to catch up on.
Are you all right, Lizzie?
Oh, I suppose it's because I didn't sleep the best last night.
Yes. Don't you think you're getting a little too old for this sort of nonsense?
I'm not over the hill yet, you know. I mean, I had to go along with them, Mrs. Davidson. I was all for forgetting the whole thing. I reckon if you can't trust what the judges say, well, who can you trust?
Lizzie, has your daughter ever mentioned her brothers?
Don't suppose she'd ever seen much of them. They were fostered out real early. Marcia spent most of her time in the home.
She didn't keep in touch with them?
Dunno. Not that she said anything. I can just thank my lucky stars that I got Marcia and Josie back. See you later, Mrs. Davidson.
Hey, you're trying to make it harder for us. Clumsy galah.
It's gonna break loose in a few seconds. Where is she? I can't hang around here any longer. You'll have to do it by yourself.
Leave that, Lizzie. Gaffney can clean it up.
They're going to try and break out of here.
Where?
I'm only talking to the governor.
There's trouble in H block. We've locked the gates, but it could spread.
I'll tell Mrs. Davidson. You come with me, Bryant.
The only phone calls you're making, sweetheart, are the ones we tell you to.
Oh, we did it. We did it.
Shut up. We haven't done nothing yet.
You don't think this is going to achieve anything, do you?
I'm sick of hearing you talk. Now, you listen to us.
Lizzie!
Sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
You see? You're on your own, aren't you? Now, you better do what we tell you to, or otherwise we're likely to get nasty. What the hell are you talking about, a bloody crank call? This is for real, Buster. Now, you wanted a good story. I've given you one. All right, look. I'll let you talk to the governor herself. Tell him. I said, tell him.
This is Erica Davidson. I'm governor of Wentworth Detention Center. Myself and another officer are being held by three prisoners in my office.
Does that satisfy you, sweetheart? Now, you get your asses over... What? You what? Listen to me, wise guy. You just ring up Wentworth and you ask to speak to the governor yourself. Bloody idiot doesn't believe me. That's the trouble, isn't it? Nobody believes the truth anymore. The world is full of people like you who only believe what they want to.
Yeah, you tell her, Jude.
You don't really think this will do any good.
Oh, it better, sweetheart. It better.
Here, have a swig of this.
We'll take your head off.
Alone.
Why? We're in this together, aren't we? And I told you this would come in handy.
Give it. Now, I want you to go and find Bea. I want you to tell her I've been held up, but I'll get there as soon as I can. And if I don't make it, she's to go ahead without me.
Well, at least they can't get through in the garden.
Look, we could get through behind them. There aren't many
use violence unless we have to. What's keeping Mrs. Davidson?
Well, how would I know? None of this would have happened if we put the ringleaders in solitary in the first place.
Those keys should have been here by now.
Fear is coming.
Getting everyone else to do your dirty work again, eh, Smith?
I don't know what you're talking about, Vera.
They'll soon run out of steam. But just before you get any more, I... Grab...
Help me!
Oh, Vera. I've been waiting years for this.
Don't be stupid, Smith.
You got a lot to answer for. You know that? Or maybe you don't know it. Maybe I'm going to teach you a few lessons. And lesson number one goes like this. We are human beings, Vera. Now you say it. Come on. Come on, say it.
Human beings.
Oh, no. Oh, no. You've got to mean it. I'll say it again.
You're human beings.
That's more like it. Sharon was murdered. Come on, say it.
Sharon was murdered.
Right. Now I wonder what would happen if you fell down the stairs. Think the cops would call an accidental death? Oh, they'd probably have to, because they couldn't prove one of us pushed you.
Killer bee.
Killer!
You wouldn't.
No. I've got a much better idea. Get that uniform off. Come on.
We'll do it for you. Come on.
All right, the press might be coming here. But all they'll print is the fact there's a riot. It won't get you another inquest.
Oh, it will if we tell them why we're rioting.
Even if there is another inquest, they're never going to convict an innocent man on hearsay.
You screws won't get it through your thick skulls, will you? He killed her. He's got to pay for it. Now, maybe your boss will get the ball rolling.
You bitch! You never get the money you're controlled, Bryant. I've seen it happen before. You think you're in charge, but they're just looking for an excuse to explode.
Lizzie! Listen, honey, I want you to give Margo a hand. And you know what to do if they play up.
Too right.
Here, make yourself at home.
Lizzie, don't!
We don't have to listen to them. Take away their big sticks and they're nothing. That's none of your cheap plonk.
Vera.
They're in the governor's office. I've got Mrs. Davidson and Meg.
You all right?
They're animals!
Hello, Mrs. Something.
Oh, thank heavens you're here, Mr. Reed. The officer told me my mum wasn't due another visit yet, but I just got to see her.
I'm sorry, those are the rules.
Yeah, I know, but I told her how urgent it was. It's Josie. She's sick and she's got to have an operation.
An operation?
Yeah. I know it's silly to worry my mum when she can't do anything, but I just thought if I could see her and tell her that
right,
I just
right.
couldn't
Look,
perhaps
I'll
visit
I'll
her
see
for a while
if
yet.
I can clear it with the governor. Mr. Paul, another word with you.
Mrs. Huntley, could you call me back later on?
Yeah, but I've got to see you now.
Mrs. Huntley, I'll get the message.
Please, Mr.
Reed. Report back immediately.
How many are there?
I don't know.
I said, how about another drink?
You want it? You get it yourself.
You want me to ruin your nightlife for you?
I'll get it for you.
No.
What's that? It's the internal phone.
Don't answer it.
Then they'll really know something's wrong, won't they?
Yeah. All right. But no tricks, all right, Davo?
Hello?
Mrs. Davidson, it's Paul Reed. We know what's going on up there. Is there any way you can let us know how many there are?
Well, if you're looking for Birdsworth and Gaffney, they should be working.
There are two of them. All right, I'm on my way up.
That could be a bit risky.
Naughty, naughty.
How about another little drink, eh?
Yeah.
She's doing the honors.
She was so scared, she was wetting herself. Oh, gee. Davo was out going for herself.
Don't listen to that silly little idiot. She's enjoying all this.
I'll leave her alone. She's all right. She's been a good help.
She's a little killer.
So what? There are plenty of murderers wandering around out there scot-free. Oh. First friend I ever had was murdered. Nobody ever did anything about that either. Whole town ganged up on her. Made her life so damn miserable she hung herself. But they were respectable. They got away with it. They just found someone they thought was a bit different and pushed and pushed. Suicide be damned. They were as guilty of killing her as if they'd lynched her themselves.
Listen, haven't you got your wires a bit crossed? We're not supposed to be in this for personal revenge. We are supposed to be setting the record straight for all of our benefits.
You know, I've only ever loved two people. And both of them were murdered. Only this time, they've got a new name for murder. Accidental death. Where the hell are those reporters?
You know, I've never had a good look around here before. You've got some real nice stuff, Mrs. Davidson.
Don't you think this has gone far enough?
You can't have the rest of the screws finding out just yet.
I'm sure they'd know by now.
We'll let you go when we're good and ready. But then again, maybe we won't.
Don't you worry, Mrs. J. I wouldn't let anything happen to you.
Mr. Davidson, it's Paul Reed. Lizzie's daughter's here to see her.
Oh,
leave it alone.
I've got to see my daughter. I'm going to let him in. Where is she, Mr. Reed?
I'm sorry, Lizzie, not until you let Mrs. Davidson and Mrs. Jackson go.
God, he's just trying to trick you, Lizzie. Get lost,
she
Reed.
She said that Josie is very ill.
What's wrong? Where is she? I've got to see her.
I said get lost.
All right, suit yourself.
You rotten mongrel, I've got to see me daughter.
We're just trying to trick you. You stupid old drunk. I told you it was a trick.
Put them in their cells.
You mean Josie isn't sick?
They're here.
About bloody time.
Okay, girls, let it rip.
Oh, right. Come on. Perfect timing.
Yeah, well, they must have got Mrs. Davidson and Mrs. Jackson out. They're okay.
Come on, honey. Fire away.
Come on now! Kill my murdered!
There must be something we can do.
Well, the police and fire brigade have been called. We'd better leave it to them.
They've all been locked in their cells.
We're missing two sets of keys.
Well, you can bet they're up there.